LA, y'all can do better than that. Make some fucking noise, LA. Yeah. Cut it out. Cut it out. Woo! God damn. It look good in here. I can't even front. Y'all look good. Give yourselves another round of applause, man. Y'all look fucking good. Now, before we get started, I feel like I gotta be honest. You know, I don't like to lie while I'm up here on stage. Coming out to the big applause, y'all standing up. A piece of me likes it. A small piece of me likes it. Another piece of me doesn't. I'm gonna tell you why, okay? Here's the thing. I feel like that's the type of shit to make people go crazy. That's how you lose your mind. You come out, people standing up, girls calling your name. Oh my God, no. Kevin, oh my goodness, no. I don't like that shit. I'm afraid to go crazy, man. That's why I humble myself. I stay in my lane, people. I stay in my financial lane. Now, let me explain what I mean when I say this, okay? Here's what I mean when I say financial lane. Here's what happens. You start to make money. When you make money, you meet other people to make money. When you meet other people to make money, you want to hang out with these people. But naturally, you want to spend money the way they spend money, but then you realize that you don't make the same type of money that these fucking people make, okay? It's very true. That's why you got to stay in your lane, all right? Certain people I don't hang out with. Athletes, I don't hang out with athletes. I used to. I stopped. Let me tell you why I stopped. Athletes don't respect money. How do I know this? From experiences. This is not a joke. This is a true story. I'm in Vegas with an athlete friend of mine. Keep in mind, he's doing a lot better than me in life, okay? Naturally, I want to keep up with him. So before we go out, he said, Kev, don't worry about nothing. I got you. Everything is on me. I said, hey, bitch, I'm a man. I'll pay for my fucking self, okay? So we go out. He get a table. I got a table. He got bottles. I got bottles. He had bitches come to the table. I didn't have no bitches. I had my aunt. My aunt was with me. I'm not going to call my aunt no bitch. I love her too much. But regardless, we having a good time, okay? Now, I'm not going to lie. I got the bill. I didn't like it. You ever get a bill so high you try to put it in the light like it's going to change? Hold up. Wait a minute. Hold on. Okay. But I said, I can't bitch about the bill. Reason why I can't bitch about the bill, because he didn't bitch about the bill. So I said, you know what? I start talking to myself. I said, Kev, just pay the bill. Pay it. So that's what I did. I paid the bill. I go to my room. I go to sleep. Here's why I don't mess with athletes. Next morning, I wake up. My boy that I was with, he called me. He said, Kev, yo, last night was crazy, wasn't it? I said, man, I had a ball. He said, well, guess what? We're going to do the same shit again tonight. I said, I'm not going to do it. I can't do it two nights in a row. Because the way that my bank account is set up. You ever start explaining your financial situation for no reason at all? I said I would, but the way my bank account is set up, the thing is, I got a checking in the savings, but all the money is in my savings, so I got to switch it to my checking, but it's going to take 3 business days. I don't think it's going to go through. I don't think it's going to go through. Athletes will mess your life up, man. They will. I'm telling you, I know this from experience, okay? Dwayne Wade, that's a good friend of mine. I love Dwayne to death. Here's the thing. I can't hang out with Dwayne no more. I'll tell you why. Dwayne tried to fuck my life up. He did. Dwayne tried to make me buy a boat. I don't even have a fucking house. I said, hey, man. I said, I don't think this is a good investment. He said, stop being a bitch. You got it. Ball out. I said, no. I would, but here's the thing. The way my bank account is set up, the thing is, I got a check in the savings, but all the money is in my savings, so I got to switch it. It's going to take too long. The boat might not be there when I get back. You can't hang out with everybody. I'll be honest, another problem of mine, I got too many financial fears. I get scared fast. I'll tell you my biggest fear when it comes to finances. My biggest fear is my credit card getting declined in front of people. I'm gonna tell you why. Here's the thing. It's not that I'm scared of my card getting declined. I just don't like it when you announce it. Like, bitch, tell me it's my card. Don't Don't put on a show. Don't come out like, Mr. Hart, didn't go through. I tried it 3 times. I even wiped it on my pants. Bitch, give me the card. Don't say all that. They don't need to know what you tried to do to make it happen. Give me the goddamn card if I punch you in the fucking throat, lady. I'm not gonna do this. That's too much. Too much. I remember one time I got scared because I thought my card wasn't gonna go through, so I cut the waitress off before she even said anything. Mr. Hart, come here, let me talk to you. No, come on this side. Let me tell you something. Listen, the way my bank account is set up, the thing is, I got a checking and a savings, but all the money is in my savings, so I don't think it's gonna go through. Just give me a second. You can't hang with everybody, man. Like right now, we star-studded tonight. Celebrities all over the place. I don't fuck with y'all no more. I used to. Stop. I don't hang with celebrities no more. I'm gonna be honest with you. Celebrities mess up your life too. Celebrities give you reality checks. How do I know this? From experience, people. Mekhi Phifer, another good friend of mine, love Mekhi to death, okay? This is when I knew I wasn't making real money. Mekhi calls me, he says, yo, Kev, hey, my son's birthday party is Saturday. Your daughter the same age, I want you to come to the party. I said, okay, well, where's the party at? He said, Disneyland. I said, done deal, I'm near. I get Disneyland, him and his son are out front, they holding hands. I don't see nobody else at the park. I said, hey, I thought you said that it was, you know, it was a birthday party. I don't see nobody else at the park. What's going on? He said, no, dude. He said, here's the thing. It's just us. I bought the park out for like 8 hours. We got it to ourselves. I said, wait a minute. Okay, what the fuck you mean you bought the park out for 8 hours? He said, it's just us. We can do what we want. I said, okay, real quick before I go in, did you pay for this already or are you looking for help? Because I'm not in a position where I can help you because the way that my bank account is set up, the thing is, I got a checking in the savings, but all my money is in the savings. I don't think my card is going to go through unless you got jeans on because you got to wipe it off. You can't hang with everybody, man. Stay in your lane. Stay in your financial lane. Now, I'm not going to lie. We went in the park. I ain't going to lie to you. Me and my daughter, we had a great time. We got on rides 5 or 6 times in a row. Now, there was a point in time when we was in the park where I lost my daughter. I didn't know where she was. But I didn't panic when I lost her. The reason why is because we were the only ones in the park. I knew eventually I would run into her again. So I took that time to get on rides that she couldn't get on. Because she's only 5, so she can't do everything. When I saw her, she was crying. I was like, come on, don't be a bitch. Like, don't act like that. That's what I said. I said that. It's not your birthday. Today's not about you. Stop bitching. Let's get on some more rides. Let's go. We got on some more rides. We had a good time. We left. I said, baby, did you have a good time? She said, dad, I had so much fun. I said, good. I had fun too. Now, here's when reality hit. Let's fast forward 3 months later. 3 months later, it's my daughter's birthday, okay? I throw my daughter a party at the house in the backyard like a normal fucking parent, okay? But don't get me wrong. I tried to go above and beyond. I really did. I had SpongeBob there, which is a big deal. I had a pony. Kids could get on the pony, walk around the yard one time, and get off. I had a bouncer, kids getting a bouncer, jump around. Like, shit was nice. It was going good. Here's why I got bad. Me and SpongeBob got into it. I got mad at SpongeBob because he kept taking his helmet off, and he was smoking cigarettes in front of the kids. And I was like, SpongeBob, don't take your helmet off. Don't smoke cigarettes in front of the fucking kids, okay? The kids think that you're really SpongeBob. SpongeBob on TV don't take his face off and show a black ass face underneath it and start smoking fucking cigarettes. So what the hell makes you think that you can? Now when I get mad, I get physical. I get hyped. So I said, put the motherfucking helmet on and put the goddamn cigarettes up, man. You'll be smoking those cigarettes out here in front of the fucking kids. Put the goddamn helmet on and put the fucking cigarettes up for shit getting real out here. I was going off. Shit was real. Here's the thing that made it bad. Nobody told me that SpongeBob was fresh out. This nigga was fresh out of jail. Here's how I found